السلام عليكم. Now inshallah we are going to start chapter 4 part 1. Okay, the title of the chapter is Ramdas and the monkey. So we have, if you look at the picture, okay, you can find that there is a monkey in the picture. We'll see what's happening in this chapter. Okay. طب who is Ramdas? Ramdas is the Indian Lascar, okay? We'll see. Let's read and we'll see who is Ramdas. Every morning when Sarah gave the birds their bread, she looked across the attic room or the attic window next door, but nobody opened it. Nobody called out good morning across the roof or gave Sarah a friendly smile. So Sarah was very kind. All what she's looking for is a friendly smile or someone to say good morning, okay? Perhaps, maybe, the Indian gentleman servants all sleep downstairs, she thought sadly. Her life was very lonely now. She was picky every day, of course. Okay, so she was very lonely. She has only Vicky as a friend. And Ermengarde, sometimes she came to her room, but not always, because she was afraid of mismention. She may punish her. So the cook and the other servants were not friendly. Sometimes at night, Ermengarde came up to Sarah's room, but it was not easy for her to come often. Then, one evening, Sarah was in her attic when she heard a noise. Okay, on the roof, she looked up, and there at the open window was a small monkey. Now, the attic room near in front of Sarah is opened, and she saw a monkey in this attic room. Oh, you dear little thing, cried Sarah. At once, the monkey jumped down and started to run around the room. Oh, he was afraid. Sarah laughed. She got up on the table and looked out of her window. And at the next window, she saw a face, the smiling face of the Indian Lascar. Okay, so Ramdas was the Indian Lascar. Okay, Lascar means the sailor. Okay, Lascar means the one who drives the ship in the sea. Okay, we call it a sailor, but Ramdas was an Indian one, an Indian Lascar. Oh, cried Sarah. Look, he looked at Sarah. He was smiling at Sarah's face. Oh, cried Sarah, have you got a monkey? He's in my room. The Lascar's name was Ramdas, and yes, it was his monkey. He gave Sarah a big smile. I'm very sorry, he said. Can I come and get him so he can jump across the attic room and get his monkey? Oh, yes, said Sarah. I think he's scared of me and he runs so fast. But can you get across the roof? Yes, Ramdas could. And a minute later, he was at Sarah's window. Soon, the monkey jumped into his arms. He's his friend. And Ramdas thanked Sarah again and again. Then he went away across the roof, back into the house next door. Sarah went to the shop 5 or 6 times a day. She was very tired. All the time she has lots of tasks to do. And when she walked past the house next door, she thought about the Indian gentleman. She was sorry for him. So Sarah, as I told you and many times, Sarah was very kind. Okay? She was thinking about the Indian gentleman, although she didn't know him. Okay? But she felt sorry for him. Why? Because he had no wife or family. He is lonely. Okay? And the doctor visited the house every day. So because he was ill, the doctor visited the house every day. Mr. Carmichael, the lawyer, visited him too. So he has two visitors every day. Okay? The Indian gentleman has two visitors every day. The doctor and the lawyer, Mr. Carmichael. Sometimes the Carmichael family or children went with him. Sometimes Mr. Carmichael took his family or his children to visit the Indian gentleman. Sarah was happy about that. It's nice to see friendly faces when you are ill, she thought. The Indian gentleman thought that too. He liked children very much, but he was a very unhappy man. Not because he is lonely, or he lived alone, or not because he is ill. We'll know the reason for his sadness, okay? Mr. Carmichael was his friend, and he talked to him a lot, but they talked about only one thing. So there is a matter that makes Mr. The Indian gentleman is so sad. We'll see what's this. So as you see in this picture, this is the Indian gentleman, and by the way, his name is Carrisford. We'll see. And this is the lawyer, Mr. Carmichael. Okay, I must find the child, said the Indian gentleman. His name was Mr. Carrisford. Okay, let's take a break and revise. We have three characters now. We have the Indian Lascar. His name is Ramdas. We have the lawyer. His name is Mr. Carmichael. And we have the Indian gentleman. His name is Mr. Carrisford. Okay, not to get confused from these names. Okay, so his name was Mr. Carrisford, the Indian gentleman. I must find her and take care of her. Huh? He's talking about a girl. But where is she? Here I am with all this money from the diamond mines. Diamond mines, they mind you with what? With Mr. Crew's friend. We'll see. And half of it is Ralph Crew's money. Oh, look. Mr. Carrisford is Mr. Crew's friend. Do you remember Mr. Crew's friend when he took all his money and ran away? We'll see the story. We'll see what's happening. Oh, Carmichael, why did I leave my friend and run away when things looked bad? Why? So he felt guilty for Sarah and for his friend, Mr. Crew. Okay? You ran away because you were ill with a fever. Do you know when you, la qadar Allah, when someone has a high temperature, okay? This means that he has a fever, okay? So he was ill with a fever, said Mr. Carmichael. It's nearly killed you, remember? So he's trying to let him feel satisfied or to let him not feel very sad as he did, okay? You ran away because you were ill with a fever, said Mr. Carmichael. It's nearly killed you, remember? And it did kill poor Ralph. This why Mr. Crew's name, full name is Ralph Crew. Okay, and do you remember when we said that Mr. Crew was dead? Okay, he was dead with a fever. Okay, so he put all his money into the mines because I was his friend. But at first we didn't find any diamonds. This is the story of the mines, okay? At first they didn't find any diamonds, and all Ralph's money was gone. I was too afraid to tell him, so I ran away. And later, when we did, so they searched again and they found diamonds. Ralph was dead. He laughed angrily, in an angry way. What a brave friend I was. Okay, he meant the opposite, of course. Okay, he felt that he was very bad friend to leave his friend before, after he was ill. It's not easy to be brave, Mr. Carmichael said quietly, when you were ill with a fever. Mr. Carrisford looked into the fire. Ramdas tells me, now he's going to talk about another situation, okay? About a little servant girl next door. The monkey ran away and Ramdas went across the roof to get him from her room. The poor child sleeps in a cold, dirty attic and works about 16 hours a day. Is Rolf's daughter living like that? I can't stop thinking about it. So, of course, he didn't know that Sarah is Rolf Krohg's daughter, okay, but he's trying to imagine the life of Sarah after her father's death, and of course he didn't know that she's Sarah. But he felt pity for the servant girl, okay, in Miss Manchin's school after Ramdas told him about her. We're going to find her one day, said Mr. Carmichael. But how? Said Mr. Carrisford. He put his hat in his hands. He can't think anymore. I have never seen her. I don't know her name. Ralph always called her Little Mrs. So he didn't even know her name, Sarah's name. We talked all time about the mines. He never told me the name of her school. Her mother was French. So did he take her to a school in France or was it in England? So he was very confused. He didn't know any information about Sarah. Okay, and he's trying to find her, and he was talking about Sarah to Mr. Carmichael, his lawyer. Well, we know there was a child at school in Paris, said Mr. Carmichael, with the name of Carew or Crow. Her father died suddenly. Okay, and a Russian family took her away with them because she was a friend of their daughter. Maybe this girl is Garth's close child. Next week, I'm going to Moscow to look for her, to search for her or to find her. So he is going to Moscow. He will travel to Moscow to try to find Sarah Crohg there. I want to go with you, but I'm not well, said Mr. Carrisford. As you know, he is ill, so he couldn't travel with Mr. Carmichael. I must find her, Carmichael. I must. Every night I dream. I see Ralph Crohg's face and he says, Tom, where is my little missus? And I have no answer for him. Mr. Carrisford took his friend's hand. Help me to find her. Help me. And that's all for chapter 4, part 1. Okay? Thank you for listening.